My name is Fraser Cain. I'm the publisher of Universe Today. Earth is the third planet from the sun, and the climate here is just right for life. Here in our solar system, there are planets both hotter and colder than Earth. So which one is the hottest? You might think it's Mercury, the planet closest to the sun. Mercury orbits at a distance of only 58 million kilometers, traveling in a blast furnace of scorching radiation. Its temperature can skyrocket to 700 Kelvin, or 426 degrees Celsius, on the sunward side. In the shadows, temperatures plunge down to 80 Kelvin, which is negative 173 degrees Celsius. Mercury sure is hot, but Venus is hotter. Venus is much further from the sun, orbiting at a distance of more than 108 million kilometers. Average temperature there is a hellish 735 Kelvin, or 462 degrees Celsius, hot enough to melt lead. Venus remains that same temperature no matter where you go on the planet. At the North Pole, 735 Kelvin. At night, 735 Kelvin. Daytime at the equator, you get the point. So why is Venus so much hotter than Mercury, even though it's further away from the sun? It's all about the atmosphere. Mercury is an airless world, not unlike the moon. Venus has a very thick atmosphere of carbon dioxide, which adds incredible pressure and traps in the heat. Consider our own planet. When you stand at sea level on Earth, you're experiencing one atmosphere of pressure. But if you could stand on the surface of Venus, and trust me, you don't want to, you'd experience 92 times as much atmospheric pressure. This is the same kind of pressure as being a kilometer underneath the surface of the ocean. Venus also shows us what happens when carbon dioxide levels just keep on rising. Radiation from the sun is absorbed by the planet, and infrared heat emitted is trapped by the carbon dioxide, which creates a runaway greenhouse effect. You might think a planet this hot, with such extreme temperatures and pressure, would be impossible to explore. And if you did, you'd be wrong. The Soviets sent a series of spacecraft called Venera, which parachuted down through the thick atmosphere and return images from the surface of Venus. Although the first few missions were failures, this taught the Soviets just how hellish the Venusian environment really is. Venera 13 made it down to the surface in 1981 and survived for 127 minutes, sending back the first color pictures of Venus's surface. So the hottest planet in the solar system is Venus. And when it comes to temperature, distance from the sun matters, but it takes a back seat to wrapping a planet in an atmospheric blanket of carbon dioxide. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Now make sure you click subscribe on our YouTube channel over here. And maybe you've still got some questions about space and astronomy, like this one or that one. And if you don't see the question you're looking for, then send me an email at info@universetoday.com.